minutes.
Sir, thank you, sir. Sir, at the time of presenting the budget, Honorable Finance Minister always mentions the quotes of great personalities. Those personalities are highly worshipped and followed by masses. And people feel those promises will get fulfilled without fail. Sir, Karnataka people are led by the highest teachings of Vishwaguru Basavanna and his Kayaka Tattva. Sir, during the presentation of budget of 2019-20, our finance minister quoted on socio-economic principles of Kayikave Kailasa and Dasoha. It means work is worship and Dasoha means serving food, health and education. Sir, Honorable Prime Minister also quoted Basavanna and his concept of Anubhava Mantapa on his 914th birth anniversary. In 12th century itself, Basavanna talked about the perfect model of parliamentary system to increase the hope of the people in government. Sir, and people should believe that the government will justify their promises. Sir, but the present government failed and broke the promises which they have made. Sir, government's rate of pending assurance rose from 11% in second sitting in July-August 2014 to 89% in January-February in 2019. Sir, the number of government promises made in Lok Sabha that have left unfulfilled increased by 300% between the 15th and 16th Lok Sabhas. Sir, this always shows how much they followed Basavanna in this situation. It reminds me a more meaningful vachana of Basavanna, which says, I will quote, sir, Kalabeda, Kulabeda, Husiya Nudiyalu Beda, Muniya Beda, Anyarige Asahya Pada Beda, Tanna Bannisa Beda, Idira Haliyalu Beda, Ide Antaranga Shuddhi, Ide Bahiranga Shuddhi, Ide Namma Koodala Sangama Devana Rolisuva Pari. Sir, it means, do not steal, do not kill, do not lie, do not become angry, do not feel bad about others, do not prize yourself, do not condemn others. This is the purity of inner and this is the purity of outer. This alone is the way win the God. Sir, the time is given to me, it's very short. Sir, let me talk about how the central government in this federal system stood with our state when Karnataka was facing problem. Sir, as you know that Karnataka is the third highest tax revenue generating state in the whole country. Karnataka has more than 12,000 full-time working IT companies and 750 MNCs. With this, our state contributes 40% of IT revenue. Sir, it is the constitutional duty of central government to help state government when the government is in the distress. Sir, in 2018-19, Karnataka has contributed 79,000 crores GST revenue. In return, we have got only 10,754 crores as compensation. Sir, 1920, Karnataka has contributed 84,000 crores. In return, we got only 18,628 crores. Sir, revised estimates for 2021 fiscal according to budget documents will result in Karnataka receiving around rupees 7,900 crores less than 28,000 crores budgeted as GST devolution. Sir, revised estimates projected GST devolution for Karnataka at rupees 20,073 crores, which is lesser 14% less compared to previous year, sir. Sir, before 2019 Lok Sabha election, centre had promised about 39,000 crores in its interim budget. But in the union budget presented after the election, the finance minister has revised the estimate to 30,919 crores. That is 9,000 crores less, and same has been further reduced in 2020-21, even before the recommendation of 15th Finance Commission came. Sir, the 15th Finance Commission, to offset the loss in devolution and revenue deficit grant, recommended to the government a special grant of 5,495 crores to Karnataka for 2021. However, the finance minister rejected the recommendation and denied the grant to the state, sir. Sir, 14 finance commission, we got 44,206 crores, where in 15th finance, we got only 31,180 crores. We got 13,000 crores lesser than previous allocation, sir. Sir, as you know, if you are aware, Karnataka faced three severe floods in 2 years, sir. Between 2019-20, during first flood, NDRF estimated around 35,000 crores as loss. Second time, sir, around 4,000 crores. Third time, around 15,000 crores. Sir, out of 54,000 crores, central government released only 2,300 crores, sir. Sir, with this little allocation, how the state has to manage and how about distressed people, sir? Sir, till today, they are not rehabilitated properly. They are in the street even today, sir. Sir, about that suburban rail, which is very essential to the Bangalore's traffic, in 2008, that budget project has announced and released only 1 crore rupees. And the same again, 1920, they again announced the project and released only 10,000 crores. Sir, in the year 2014, the project got estimated around 12,000 crores. Now it has reached to 18,000 crores. Sir, I am not asking when this project is going to complete. Just I wanted to know when this project is going to start. Sir, I explain the financial status of our state today, how it has happened. Sir, in 2019-20, Karnataka debt was 3.27 lakh crore. For this, we are paying around 19,000 crores interest per annum, sir. Sir, recently our Karnataka CM said, before March, we are going to cross 4 lakh crores as debt. For this, we are going to pay around 24,216 crores per annum, sir. Sir, in this situation, continues like this, and also if the GST compensation period is not extended, then Karnataka will move from revenue surplus state to revenue deficit surplus state, sir. Sir, money will not have to be borrowed to even take care of salaries, administration, and service debt by leaving development activities, sir. Sir, I would like to quote an example. Our transport department of Karnataka under crisis today, sir. During the assembly session in the last week, the concerned minister has said, from last 7 months, the state government struggling to pay the salaries. They paid only half salaries in December and yet to decide for the month of January, sir. Sir, the present situation, they could afford only fuel for the buses, not for the salaries. Sir, Bangalore Metro Transportation Corporation, this BMTC, floated a tender asking the banks and financial institutions for loan of rupees 250 crores in December, and recently the department thinking of mortgage of the important valuable assets in the department, sir. Sir, recently they have mortgaged BMTC head office.
Honourable member, sir, please start
conclusion. Sir, unfortunately, even the government is failing to pay salaries of the midday meal and of Anganwadi workers. Sir, Kannadigas, we are given 25 MPs. Out of 28 MPs to BJP government and 4 cabinet ministers, we will now are 3. But for this, we are receiving receiving so many gifts like this, sir. Sir, it is our fate, I think. Sir, finally, I will come to this thing, sir. About Karnataka, I would like to quote one more important promise made by the finance minister, which is not fulfilled even today. Regarding IBPS exams, we have asked to conduct the exam in regional languages and also revoke the present notification to as it was in before 2014. Sir, but FM has agreed, one of the demand and announced to conduct the examination in 13 regional language on the floor of the house, but till today it has not been implemented. Sir, according to me, sir, I'll tell you finally in Kannada. Sir, now Nirmala Sitaraman bagge, now tumbana madam bagge tumbana nama Karnataka nirikshe ittukondittu. Yake antandre madam bandiddu ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ನಿರೀಕ್ಷೆ ಇತ್ತು. ಆದರೆ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ತನಕ ಐಬಿಪಿಎಸ್ದು ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಏನು 13 ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ತನಕ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ದೇ ಇರೋದು ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರಿಗೆ ಅವಮಾನ ಮಾಡ್ದಂಗೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಈಗಲಾದರೂ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುರಾಗ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಅವರು ಇಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಮತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಸರ್ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳೋದಿಷ್ಟೇ, ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿರೋ ಅಂತ ಏನು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ತುಂಬ ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಐಬಿಪಿಎಸ್ನ. ಯಾಕೆಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜನ ಸರ್ ನನಗೆ ನೂರಾರು ನಮಗೆ ಇದು ಬರ್ತವೆ, ಏನೋ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಸೇಜಸ್ ಬರ್ತವೆ, ಜನ ಇವತ್ತು ಹದಿನೆಂಟು ಸಾವಿರ ಉದ್ಯೋಗಗಳು ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್. ಹದಿನಾಲ್ಕರಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತನಕ ಕಷ್ಟ ತುಂಬಾ ಇದೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಕರೋನಾ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಉದ್ಯೋಗ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತುಂಬಾ ಕಷ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಜನ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಉದ್ಯೋಗ ಕೊಡೋದು ಕಷ್ಟ ಇದೆ. ನಾನು ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೂಲಕ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದೇನಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈಗಲಾರು ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟಂತ ಪ್ರಾಮಿಸ್ನ ಅದು ಹೌಸ್